we present Julius Caesar by William Shakespeare.
A holiday? What? No, you not being mechanical. You ought not walk upon a laboring day without the sign of your profession. Speak, what trade art thou?
Why, sir, a carpenter.
Where is thy leather apron and thy rule? What dost thou with thy best apparel on? You, sir, what trade are you?
Truly, sir, in respect of a fine workman, I am but, as you would say, a cobbler.
But what trade art thou? Answer me directly.
A trade, sir, that a hoper may use with a safe conscience, which is indeed, sir, a mender of bad souls.
What trade, thou knave, thou naughty knave? What trade?
Nay, I beseech you, sir, be not out with me. Yet if you be out, sir, I can mend you.
What means thou by that? Mend me, thou saucy fellow.
Why, sir, cobble you.
Ah, thou art a cobbler, art thou?
Truly, sir, all that I live by is with the awl. I meddle with no tradesmen's matters, nor women's matters. But with all I am indeed, sir, a surgeon to old shoes. When they are in great danger, I recover them. As proper men as ever trod upon neat's leather have gone upon my handiwork.
But wherefore art not in thy shop today? Why dost thou lead these men about the streets?
Truly, sir, to wear out their shoes to get myself into more work. But indeed, sir, we make holiday to see Caesar. To rejoice in his triumph.
Wherefore rejoice? What conquest brings he home? What tributaries follow him to Rome to grace in captive bonds his chariot wheels? You blocks, you stones, you worse than senseless things. Oh, you hard hearts, you cruel men of Rome. Knew you not, Pompey? Many a time and oft have you climbed up to walls and battlements, to towers and windows, yea, to chimney tops, your infants in your arms, and there have sat the livelong day with patient expectation to see great Pompey pass the streets of Rome. And when you saw his chariot but appear, have you not made an universal shout that Tiber trembled underneath her banks to hear the replication of your sounds made in her concave shores? And do you now put on your best attire? And do you now cull out a holiday? And do you now strew flowers in his way that comes in triumph over Pompey's blood? Begone! Run to your houses, fall upon your knees, pray to the gods to intermit the plague that needs must light on this ingratitude.
Go, go, good countrymen, and for this fault assemble all the poor men of your sort. Draw them to Tiber banks, and weep your tears into the channel, till the lowest stream do kiss the most exalted shores of all.
See. Where their basest metal be not moved, they vanish tongue-tied in their guiltiness. Go you down that way towards the Capitol. This way will I. Disrobe the images if you do find them decked with ceremonies.
May we do so? You know it is the Feast of Lupercal.
It is no matter. Let no images be hung with Caesar's trophies. I'll about and drive away the vulgar from the streets. So do you too, where you perceive them thick. These growing feathers plucked from Caesar's wing will make him fly an ordinary pitch. Who else would soar above the view of men and keep us all in servile fearfulness?
Caesar speaks!
Calpurnia!
Here, my lord.
stand you directly in Antonius' way when he doth run his course.
Aye.
Antonius?
Caesar, my lord.
Forget not in your speed, Antonius, to touch Calpurnia. For our elders say the baron, touched in this holy chase, shake off their sterile curse.
I shall remember. When Caesar says do this, it is performed.
Set on and leave no ceremony out.
Caesar!
Ha! Who calls?
Bid every noise be still. Peace yet again.
Who is it in the press that calls on me? I hear a tongue shriller than all the music, cries Caesar. Speak. Caesar is turned to hear.
Beware the Ides of March.
What man is that?
A soothsayer bids you beware the Ides of March.
Set him before me. Let me see his face.
Hello. Come from the throng. Look upon Caesar.
What sayest thou to me now? Speak once again.
Beware the Ides of March.
He is a dreamer.
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.